Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. So, the rumors were all true. The American Express increased the annual fee of the Platinum card to $695. But before we gather the pitchfork and run after them or start praising Amex for adding all those new benefits and credits, let's just take a step back and do a deep dive and do an in-depth calculation and see if it's truly worth that new $695 annual fee. Okay, let's start with the new welcome offer. So, public offer as of right now is 100,000 reward points, and that's what I get on my referral as well. But if you do a quick incognito search, you will be able to find this 125K membership reward points after you spend $6,000 on the first 6 months. Not only that, you will also be able to earn 10x points on restaurant and shop spa, which basically means small businesses that accepts American Express credit cards, up to $25,000 in the first 6 months. Although this quote-unquote new welcome bonus is nice and all, it's nothing that we haven't seen before when the annual fee was just $550. I personally got similar bonus when I applied. Now, granted, it was only 100,000 reward points, but the annual fee at the time was $550 and the spend requirement was only $5,000 in the first 6 months. And I think gas station and supermarket are better 10x categories, which is what I got with my welcome offer. So this new quote-unquote increased welcome offer certainly doesn't justify the increase in the annual fee. So let's see how Amex tries to justify the increase in annual fee. So Amex is saying that although we increased the annual fee to $695, we have added this new perks and benefits that adds up to more than $1,400 in value. But are they really worth $1,400 in value though? Let's find out. First up, we have this new $200 hotel credit. Now, it would be nice if this credit would count towards any hotel booking, but that's not the case here. It will only count if you book your stay through Amex's Fine Hotel and Resort program or the Hotel Collection. Only good thing about this credit is that you don't have to enroll or activate anything in order to utilize this credit. But keep in mind, you do have to use either Fine Hotels and Resort program or the Hotel Collection. Second credit we have is the old $200 airline incidental fee credit. This one also has some restriction. First, you have to pick an airline, then use the credit for only airline incidentals such as check bags and in-flight purchases. There are some clever ways to trigger this credit, but we're not gonna go over that in this video. To be honest, this credit is also pretty annoying to use nonetheless. Now moving down the list, we have the most useless credit of all, in my opinion of course, the ridiculous $300 Equinox credit. Now, if you don't already know, Equinox is a luxury high-end fitness club or gym, whatever you wanna call it, which membership starts anywhere from $200 to $275 a month depending on what plan you choose. In my opinion, this $25 monthly credit is totally useless. Frankly, I'm just gonna ignore this credit, not even gonna count this at all. Now, moving down the list, we have my old favorite, the Uber credit. $15 in Uber cash for either rides or eats order every month plus $20 in December. I love this credit and use it every month. Probably the easiest credit to use of them all. Not much to say about this credit. Moving down the list, we have another new credit, which is $240 digital entertainment credit. $20 each month for either Peacock, New York Times, Audible, or SiriusXM. Not going to lie, I'm very disappointed in this credit. I wish it was one of the major streaming services like Netflix or Disney Plus, but I guess it is what it is. Now, I did have a subscription to Audible, the lower tier one. I think it costs $7.50, so this works out for me, but this credit could have been a lot better in my opinion. Now, moving down the list yet again, we have the old $100 global entry credit. Basically, you will get this credit whenever you apply for the global entry or TSA pre-check using the Platinum card. Probably another easier credit to use. Global entry will allow you to skip the long airport security line, and that's pretty much it. Moving down the list yet again, we have the $100 Saks Fifth Avenue credit. As you guys already know, that's split up to $50 on semi-annual basis. Lastly, we have another new credit, which is $179 clear credit. Now, The Clear is similar service as the Global Entry. This will allow you to breeze through security, as they put it. Frankly, I think this credit is redundant if you already have Global Entry, but I guess if you wanna get both, you can get both and choose which line is faster and walk through there. But again, not very necessary. And finally, we have one of the newest perks, which is Global Dining Access by Resy. It's a restaurant reservation service. Frankly, I'm never gonna use it. And that's pretty much it. Now on paper, if you combine all the new and old credits, you get about $1,519. And subtracting this $695 annual fee, you're still ahead $824. But as we all know, not everyone will be able to use because of the ridiculous restrictions that American Express have put on them. So, is American Express Platinum Card still worth getting in 2021 after the annual fee increase? I think this answer is a bit harder to answer now, and it will depend on the individual situation and how well you will be able to use those new statement credits. Now, with that being said, let's talk about my situation and see how I will be able to use this credit and get the maximum value out of the Platinum Card. So first, let's start with the old credits. So the old credits I've already used are $100 Global Entry credit. I just got my card and I activated it, so that's done. $200 Incidental credit, I used that as well, that's done. I have used the first half of the Saks credit, so $50. And I'm gonna count full $200 Uber credit because I have used this in the past and I will continually use this credit. Adding all that up, that comes to $550. Now let's talk about the new credit. I think the most useful for me will be the hotel credit, because I was already planning on using the Amex's Fine Hotel and Resort program, and getting this $200 is pure coincidental bonus for me. So I'm going to count full $200 for this one. Next, I'm just going to ignore the Equinox credit, no use for me there at all.
Now for the digital entertainment credit, I was already paying Audible $7.95 for the lower tier subscription, but now I have changed it to a higher tier subscription, which cost about $14.95 a month. So this credit is semi useful for me. I'm not gonna count the full $240 towards it, but I'm gonna count $100, because if you do $7.95 times 12, that'll be about $95, and if you consider taxes and fees, that's probably over $100, but I'm just gonna count $100 towards this credit.
And like I said, I'm just gonna ignore the Clear credit because I don't know if I'm ever gonna use it or not. If I do, maybe I'll count it, but not really sure about that one because I've already got Global Entry, and for me, I don't think it's that necessary. So now adding that $550 plus this new $300 statement credit comes out to be $850. And remember, since I got this card in April, my annual fee was still $550. But even if the annual fee was $695, I'm still coming out ahead about $155. Keep in mind, this is just with the credits. I haven't even added the welcome bonus, which was 100,000 reward points, and all the other benefits like lounge access, hotel and car rental status, and insurance and protections. So for me, it's definitely worth keeping it for at least one more year. I will try to ask for the retention offer when the new annual fee hits on my card on April 2022, and definitely reevaluate everything and decide whether it will be worth keeping it for another year. But as of right now, this card has been worth it for me so far. Alright, that was my in-depth analysis on the new annual fee Platinum Card. Please let me know in the comments if you still think this is the best travel credit card, or does Chase Sapphire Reserve become a little more competitive. Also, let me know if I miss anything. I would love to hear what you have to say. Other than that, that's all I got for today. Let me know if you have any question in the comment section below. But until then, I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.